Good afternoon, everybody. So the fifth session of relations and functions of discrete mathematical structures. In yesterday's class, I have given you the idea about the composition of functions. The last idea which has been left out in this unit for BE, CSC and ISC students as well as MCA students, invertible functions. What is an invertible function? A function f a to b is said to be invertible. Invertible means inverse, okay. In matrix language also we use inverse of the determinant matrix. So invertible means inverse. A function f a to b is said to be invertible if there exists a function g from b to a such that g composition f must be I suffix a and g f composite g must be I b, where I a is the identity function on capital A and I b is the identity function on capital B. What is an identity function? Already in the previous classes we have discussed it. What is an identity function? If the image of every element is itself, then it is called an identity function. So whatever may be the elements in domain A, capital A, say 1, 2, 3, its image should be again 1, 2, 3 only. Image of 1 should be 1, 2 should be 2, 3, 3. Such function is called identity function. So here continuation, yesterday's class composition we have calculated, same way the composition of function. I should get g composite f as ia and f composite g as ib, where ia is the identity function on capital A and ib is the identity function on capital B. So if we work the problems, we should get these identities properly, then we can say the function f is invertible. You see that f is a function from a to b, g is a function from b to a, inverse. Just like in second semester you have learned Laplace transformation, so inverse Laplace transformation. Laplace transformation is a function of, you will get answers in function time in S, in inverse Laplace in terms of T. Like that, f is a function from A to B, its inverse is from B to A, you should get the composition as IA, one more composition IB. IA and IB are the identity functions of capital A and B respectively. I am showing you some examples. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to A, B, C, D. Determine whether the following functions from A to B are invertible or not. Function is given to you, 1A, 2A, 3C, 4D, again 1A, 2C, 3D and 4D. What should I do first? Let me calculate G composite F of 1. Yesterday's definition, G of F of 1. That is equal to g of a, but g of a, you can see this, g of a does not exist, because in function g nowhere you can see the alphabet a. Complete function you can look into it, therefore I can go for the second slide very easily. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, no a, b, c, d are starting. So g composite f of 1 does not exist, g composite f of 2, f of 2, g of a again, it is also does not exist, 3 does not exist, 4 also does not exist. Same way f composite g, in f also what the first elements are in the domain, 1, 2, 3, 4 only. So again these 4 also does not exist. So here what happened in this problem, g composite f of the elements are does not existing, f composite g also does not exist. It may not be some element also, it is not at all existing. Therefore, f and g are not invertible. Those two functions are not invertible. Okay. Next problem. Let a is equal to b is equal to r, real number. Show that f from a to b defined by f of a is equal to a plus 1 for a belong to a is invertible. See, there are some theorems at the end of this section I will show you, based on the theorems also we can prove whether the functions are invertible or not. Such theorem I am going to use this in this problem. You can see that we should find out f composite g or g composite f, correct? But here only f is defined, only f is defined, there is nothing like a function g. But even though they are asking whether this function is invertible, not asking, they are asking you to prove that it is invertible. So what is the theorem I am using? Solution by known theorem. If f is 1 to 1 and on 2, then f is invertible. If a function is 1 to 1 and on 2, in other words, it has 1 to 1 correspondence, bijective. If the function is bijective, then you can say that the given function is invertible. So what I have to prove? 1 to 1 on 2. We know very well, we have seen lot of examples for 1 to 1 and on 2 functions. So see that, let us consider f of x1 is equal to f of x2. It what happens? X1 plus 1 is equal to x2 plus 1, because the definition of f of a is a plus 1. So x1 plus 1 is equal to x2 plus 1. 1 1 get cancels, x1 is equal to x2. Therefore the given function is 1 to 1. On 2, let f of x is equal to y, that is a plus 1 is equal to y. What is a x is equal to y minus 1? Definitely y minus 1 is a real number, y minus 1 is a real number, that is it is in B. So for every y minus 1 in real number, that is B, there exists x belong to another real number, which is A. Here A and B both are real numbers, that is domain and codomain are real numbers. So the function is onto, hence f is onto, therefore the function is invertible. This is how you have to use the theorems for the proof. Okay, so if f is 1 to 1 and onto, it has 1 to 1 correspondence, then I can say f is invertible. Now whether the following functions are invertible, I think we have three problems. A is equal to B is equal to, set is given 1 2 3 4 5, then f is defined 1 3 2 2 3 4 4 5 5 1. Similarly, previous problem, how we have done functions, ax plus b e power 2x plus 5. So that ax plus b and e power 2x plus 5, you can do it as assignment, because previously second example I have shown you, with a plus 1, how can you prove that 1 to 1 and on to, and you know already how to prove 1 to 1 and on to also. So those two you can do it. For this we can draw the arrow diagram. F is equal to 1 3 2 2 3 4 4 5 5 1. 1 is, image of 1 is 3, 2 is itself, 3 is 4, 4 is 5, then 5 is 1. What we are observing in this arrow diagram, every element in A has unique pre-image in codomain again A. Every element in A has unique pre-image in capital A. Same way, every element in codomain A has unique pre-image in A. We already discussed what is 1 to 1 correspondence. If unique image in domain for unique image in codomain, if it exists, both unique exist, then it is 1 to 1 correspondence. Therefore, since every element of domain capital A has unique image and every element in codomain has unique pre-image, hence the function is 1 to 1 and on 2. So if it is 1 to 1 and on 2, thus the function is invertible. That's what we have seen in the theorem previous result. Other two you have to do it as assignment. Now same just like yesterday's class only, 2a plus 1 b by 3 given, a belong to a, b belong to b, compute g composite f and show that g composite f is invertible, whether it is 1 to 1 or on 2. What is g composite f? Inverse. Very simple, g composite f, it is g of f of x, g of f of x is 2x plus 1, then what is g? It is b by 3, therefore 2x plus 1 by 3. It is evident I have given, because you know already how to prove the function is 1 to 1 and on 2, in the examination you should not write like this, it is evident. You have to prove that the G composition F is 1 to 1 and on 2. It is very easy because capital A, B, C are again real numbers. Is it 1 to 1? Yes, you can see that 2x plus 1 by 3. So, dx1 will be equal to x2. Then for this 2x plus 1 by 3, you can find some number in domain also. So, it will be 1 to 1 and on 2 you have to prove. Hence, G composite F is invertible. What I am finding? What is G composite F inverse? Let G composite F of x is equal to C. Then 2x plus 1 by 3 is equal to C. So, x is equal to 3C minus 1 by 2. What happens? Inverse 3C minus 1 by 2. Okay. So, G inverse is 3C minus 1 by 2 that I have calculated. One more theorem is also there. Only example we are taking. Theorem I am going to state afterwards. For the functions F and G from real number to real number given below, verify that G composite F inverse is it equal to F inverse composite G inverse. Just recollect, I am always I will be quoting, you know, from previous classes also I have done that, examples to understand very clearly from matrix theory. Because every mathematician knows, if anybody asks which part of the mathematics you like very much, which is very easiest mathematics, part of the mathematics means people will spell out immediately matrices and determinants. Why? There is no formulas, there is no nothing, simple calculations, addition, subtraction, multiplication only it will be there. So, it is easy to remember the results. So, here also if you want to remember, you can compare with the matrix theory. What is AB inverse? It is B inverse into A inverse, correct? Same way, G composite F inverse is F inverse composite G inverse. For the first problem, let us see. G composite F of x, G of F of x, what is F of x? 2x, here it is defined, 2x, then that is 3x minus 1. So, directly I have written 2x means what happens? 2x, here in place of x, you have to write this 2x. So, 3 into 2x, so 6x minus 2, this is G composite F. Then what is G composite F inverse? Y plus 2 by 6, you can calculate it, 6x minus 2 is equal to, this 6x minus 2 is equal to, 6x minus 2 is equal to y. So, what is x? Y plus 2 by 6, that is G composite F inverse, my first equation. What is F inverse? Y by 2. G inverse y plus 2 by 3, see here, this is 2x, c is equal to 2x, so x is equal to c by 2 or y by 2. Then here y is equal to 3x minus 2, so x is equal to y plus 2 by 3, that is what we have written here, f inverse y by 2, g inverse. Now make the composition, f inverse composite g inverse, it is f inverse of g inverse of x. What is G inverse? Y plus 2 by 3. What is G inverse? Y plus 2 by 3. What is F inverse? Whatever it is there Y, you divide again by 2. So, the total factor will be divided by 2. It will be multiplied with 3. Divide by 2, cross multiply 1 by 2. Therefore, you will get Y plus 2 by 6, second equation. Hence, by 1 and 2, what we can observe, we get G composite F inverse is equal to F inverse composite G inverse. It is also a theorem in the book. Now, I am quoting the theorems. This is what we have used. A function F from A to B is invertible if and only if it is 1 to 1 and on 2. What you have to prove? Consider it is invertible, prove that the function is 1 to 1 and on 2. Consider it is 1 to 1 and on 2, prove that the function is invertible. Second theorem, if F is A to B, G is B to Z, I have done a problem on this, are invertible functions. Then what is G composite F? It is from A to C, is an invertible function, composition is also invertible, and G composite inverse, G composition F inverse will be equal to F inverse composite G inverse. I have given proof in the previous class on composition of functions, some theorems. say since the time is very short, okay, I am making note of the theorems which are important. So theorem 1, theorem 2, theorem 3. This is not much important, but just it has a result we can remember. If a function f from a to b is invertible, then it has unique inverse, okay. Further, if f of a is equal to b, then f inverse is equal to b. You know that. If I take some numbers, integers 3, its additive inverse is minus 3, multiplicative inverse is 1 by 3. For 3, I will have only one unique inverse, 1 by 3, multiplicative. For 3, again minus 3, additive, unique. Same way in the functions, if a function f from a to b is invertible, then it has unique inverse. This also we know, f of a is equal to b, then what is f inverse of b is equal to a. Just like Laplace of sin t, Laplace of sin t is nothing but 1 by a square plus 1. If I take inverse to this side, so L inverse of 1 by a square plus 1, which is nothing but sin t. Same way, f of a is equal to b, my f inverse of b is a. Fourth theorem, all these three statements are equivalent. This follows from the first theorem. What is the first theorem? Invertible if and only if it is 1 to 1 and on to. Equivalent means what? All the statements we can have. So let A and B be finite sets with mod A is equal to mod B. Here the number of elements in the sets are also equal. And F be a function from A to B. Then the following statements are equivalent. F is 1 to 1 on to invertible. How to prove this? First assume F is 1 to 1. Prove that it is on to. Okay, then assume it is 1 to 1 invertible. Assume f is on 2, prove that f is invertible. So, three combinations you have to prove. Okay, so the statements are equivalent in the sense that if one is there, others can be assumed. In the last class itself, I told, see, Grimaldi is our textbook, but for understanding purpose, we can see Dr. D.S. Chandrasekhar textbook for understanding purpose, neatly presented. And he has considered all the materials which has been in the Grimaldi textbook. Therefore, that is why I have quoted here. Refer the proof for the theorems 1 to 4, whatever I have quoted in the textbook by Dr. D.S. Chandrasekhar entitled Discrete Mathematical Structures. So, in this book, in the topic Invertible Functions, you can see all the proof for 1 to 4 theorems. Out of that, the first two theorems are the most important one. Third and fourth you have to note. Fourth theorem automatically it is a reflection of the first theorem. See, with this what I told, the fifth unit, okay, the fifth unit of discrete mathematical structures is completed. It consists of complete relation, function, what are all we have seen, Cartesian product, then relation, then function, different types of functions, then pigeonhole principle, composition of function, then invertible functions. So, this comprises one unit in the discrete mathematical structures, which is the fifth unit. So, you prepare well, because the questions will be asked in almost all the topics, even for 2 marks, 3 marks, 5 marks also they ask the questions. So, I have detailed given what are all you have to read. Problems 1 or 2, because time is short, 1 or 2 we have worked. Remaining problems, whichever I have given it as assignment, you have to work. Now, I am passing on to the sixth unit, second unit of this relations and functions. What is that? 0, 1 matrices. Why I am referring always matrix also, you can note this. Here also we are having the matrices. 0, 1 matrices. What is the meaning of that? Means in a matrix you can see only zeros and ones. There is a particular type of matrix called identity matrix. It also consists of zeros and ones, but it is a set pattern except the leading diagonal. In leading diagonal you can see 1, 1, 1, remaining elements are 0. That is identity matrix. Here it is not so. In this matrix also you can see zeros and ones, but it depend upon how the relation is given. let capital R be the relation from A to B, so that R is a subset of A cross B. Let M suffix ij, what are the elements Ai comma bj? We know that in a relation we will have ordered pairs, and assign the values 1 or 0 according to the following rule. If the ordered pair is present in that relation belong to R, here R refers for relation, not for real number. In the 5th chapter, 5th unit, R refers for real number. Okay, here R refers for relation. There also relation, sometimes we write R. We are very specific in the problems. If you give R, it is a real number. Here it is relation. So if you write, if you have that element in R, then write it as 1. If you don't have it, write it as 0. Okay, this is 0, 1 matrices. So the M cross N matrix, it need not be diagonal, it need not be square, it can be rectangle also. So the M cross N matrix formed by this Mij's 1 or 0 is called the matrix of the relation R, or the relation matrix R, and is denoted by M suffix R. In some books, M bracket R, that is why both I have given M suffix R or M of R. Since M of R contains only zeros and ones, as its elements M of R is also called the 0, 1 matrix for R. Understood? Since M of R contains only 0 and 1 as its elements, so M of R is also called the 0, 1 matrix. One more concept in this is directed graph or digraph. Digraph of R, that means digraph of the relation capital R. See, let R be a relation on a finite set capital A, then R can be represented pictorially with arrows and the elements within the circles. The elements we have to write within the circle, and the element representation, in other words, the ordered pair will be represented in arrows, is called directed graph of R or digraph of R. What is a digraph? It is the pictorial representation of the relation, one line. Digraph, it is a pictorial representation of the relation. What is important? The element should be written in circles. The element should be written in circles, and ordered pair should be represented with arrows. This is digraph or directed graph. Now I am passing on to a problem. See, all possible things in one question I have asked. Write down R as a set of ordered pairs, draw the digraph of R, determine the in degree and out degree of the vertices, then write the matrix. What is the condition? A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and let R be the relation on capital A defined by X or Y, that is X is related to Y, if and only if X divides Y. This is a repetition. Already we know how to write the relation. Recollect the ideas. First you have to write A cross A, then the relation. Okay. So write down the set of R as ordered pairs. These three are in this unit, new. Digraph, determine in degree and out degree, write the matrix. See that A cross A, whatever I have told, A cross A, it consists of 4 elements. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, and 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4. What is the condition? X divides Y, be careful, X divides Y. So yes, 1 divides 1, 1 divides 2, 1 divides 3, 1 divides 4, but 2 doesn't divide 1, leave it. 2 divides 2, again 2 doesn't divide 3, 2 divides 4, 3 1, 3 2, 3 3, 3 4 not occurs, 3 3 will be there, 3 divides 3. Then don't get any confusion, don't write 4 2. Because 4 doesn't divide 2, but 4 divides 4. x divides y. So this element should divide this. So this is your R. Okay. This is the digraph of that particular R. Digraph of R. Okay. I will show you in the board also very clearly. So what is the relation we got? R is equal to 1 1, okay, 1 1, 1 2, 1 3, 1 4, then 2 2, 2 4, then 3 3, 3 4, sorry, 3 3, 4 4. These are the elements in the relation R. These are the elements in the relation R. How to write the digraph? Circle 1 element, 2, 3, 4. These are the 4 elements in that. These are the 4 elements in that set. Okay. These are the 4 elements in that set. Now, 1 to 1, because in the computer we cannot draw properly, that is why it looking like that. See, 1 comma 1, that means start the edge and end it with this. This is 1 to 1. Then 1 to 2, then 1 to 3, then 1 to 4. See that arrows, where it starts, it has to go. Arrow 1 to 4, then 2 to 2, start here, 2 to 2, then 2 to 4, 2 to 4, then 3 to 3, finally 4 to 4. This is how we should write. See these lines in the pictorial, in the slides it is very clear, but this circle it may not be very clear. So, like this we have shown. So, this how you should write, it should start and end with the same element. This is called the digraph of R relation. Digraph of the relation. I will show you in slides also. Then vertices, okay, what is in degree and what is out degree? For one problem, I will do it on the board so that you will be very clear. What are the vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4 vertices are there. Now for 1, what is meant by in degree means the arrow mark should end in this. In degree, the arrow mark should come to this 1. See here, only one arrow mark is there. Others are not there. In degree coming to that element, that is the idea. So for element 1, it is 1. For element 2, you can see there are 2 in degrees. For element 3, again there are 2 in degrees. For element 4, 1, 2, 3 in degrees. Is it clear? So in degree, the element should end, or the edge should end there itself. So in simple words, what we can say, you how many arrow marks are there with that element? So here only 1, here 2, here 2, here 1, 2, 3. Those are called in degree. Then out degree, how the line is moving or how the elements are mapped. In other words, how many arrows are going out of that element. So for 1, please note that this is called a loop element, 1 comma 1. It comes in degree as well as in the out degree, because here it is end, therefore in degree. Here it starts, therefore out degree. How many out degrees are there for 1? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 out degrees. For this, 1, and this is also 2. For the third element, only 1. For the fourth element, again it is 1. So how many arrows are coming out of that element we have to check. How many elements are coming out? In other words, how many arrows are coming out? How many elements are mapped? Whatever the way we want, we can express it. So for 1, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, I am telling this is a loop element. It will come in degree as well as out degree. Here 1, 2. Here only 1. Here also only 1. Okay. Then what is the next question is asked in that? What is the matrix representation? First one is relation. Yes, I have written the relation. Then digraph. Yes, I have written the digraph. What are the in degree and out degrees? I have given what are the in degrees and out degrees. Now I should say how to write the matrix. M of R, matrix of the relation. Matrix of the relation. See, for your reference, I am telling here in the slides we have not put this. 1, 2, 3, 4 elements are there. Same way 1, 2, 3, 4 in capital A. These are the elements. Now go to the relation. 1 to 1. Yes, 1 comma 1 is there. Therefore, the value in the matrix is 1. Then 1 comma 2. Yes, it is there. 1 comma 3. It is there. 1 comma 4. It is also there. Then 2 comma 1, it is not in the relation, therefore 0. 2 comma 2, yes. 2 3 is not there in the relation. Then 2 4, yes, it is present. Then 3 1, 3 1 doesn't present. 3 2 does not. 3 3, yes. 3 4, 0. Then for the element 4, 4 1, it is not there in the relation. 4 2, not there in the relation. 4 3, not there in the relation. 4 4. This is the matrix of the given relation capital R. Okay. So, whether the elements are present. See, these things we cannot show it in the slide and everything. If you want, it is a very clear idea. You can write it, whatever the elements are there in the set. So, you can compare 1 1, 1 2, 1 3, 1 4. 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 2 4. Similarly, for 3 and 4, you can see that. So, this is how we have to write the matrix of M, that is M of R. Okay. So, matrix of M. Now, you can see the slide. R is 1 1, 1 2, 1 3, 1 4, 2 2, 2 4. This is what I have shown in the, we cannot show it very clearly. Therefore, this is how we have shown the loop element. Starts from 1, ends at 1. 2 2, 3 3, 4 4, okay. Remaining it is very clear, arrows. Then what about in degree, out degree? We have seen this. 1 2 3 4 are the vertices. So 1 2 2 3 4 2 1 1. Then what is the matrix? 1 1 1 1 0 1, that's what. See, it is not like the identity matrix, that's what I told. So it is just like matrix with zeros and ones. Let us take next example. If R is equal to x comma y, x greater than or equal to y is the relation defined on the set. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Write down R as a set of ordered pairs. Draw the digraph in degree, out degree and the matrix. Same type of question. I have given the answer also. A cross A I have written. R 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2. What is the condition they have asked? X should be greater than or equal to y. See that. 1 is greater than or equal to 1. 1 is equal to 1. So 1 2 1 3 doesn't occur now. 2 1, 2 2, 3 1, 3 2, 3 3, 4 1, 4 2, 4 3, 4 4, because x is greater than or equal to y. So this is the digraph. This is the digraph. Only 1 to 1 is here. That's all. Then 2 to 1, see the arrow mark. 2 to 1, 2 to 2, okay. Then 3 to 1, 3 to 2, 3 to 3, then 4 to 1. For all the elements it will come 4 to 2, 4 to 3, then 4 to 4. This is the digraph. What about the in degree, out degree? We can check. See, 1 has only 1 in degree. 1, 2, 3, 4 in degrees, but only 1 out degree. Correct? Check this. See that in degree is 4, out degree is 1. Same way for the vertices 2, 3, 4, it has been mentioned. Then what is the matrix? it is written. Only 1, 1 is there. No 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. That's why these three elements are 0. You have 2, 1, 2, 2. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. 3, 1, 3, 2. Sorry, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3 and 4, 4. This is the matrix of that relation. Now, some different versions of the question. We have given the condition and you have, we ask you to write the relation, okay, a matrix in degree, out degree and digraph. Different version. The matrix of the relation on a set A, that is A, B, C, D, E, okay, is given. The matrix is given. So, now it is not required to write the A cross A, because from this I can find out directly my relation. What is the relation? The elements are A, B, C, D, E. Therefore, this represents A, comma A. This represents A, B. Then, no other elements, okay. Second row starts from B. B, A is not there, B, B is not there. B, C present. B, D present. Then C, D. C, A. Then D, B. D, C. E, A. That is how that you have to define the matrix. Okay. See that. R is equal to whatever I have told, R is equal to AA, this is AB, BC, okay, BD, then CD, CE, okay, BD, DC, sorry, DC, DB, DC, finally EA. So, I have given the relation, remaining things you have to work, whatever the question asked. Write down R as the set of ordered pairs, that is what we have given in the, here it is a previous slide. Draw the digraph, you have to write it. Determine in degree and out degree of the vertices in the graph. One more problem, what we can do, we will give you the digraph of the relation on the set again A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, A, B, C, D, E, F, it is given. You have to write the same things, I will show you, you have to write everything. R as the set of order pair, draw the digraph. Sorry, digraph is given, matrix, determine in degree, out degree. What are the elements here? Please note that here reflexive elements are not there. That means AA is not there. What are the elements you have? A comma B, A comma D, two elements with respect to A. Then BC, BE, with respect to C, there is no other element. C, no arrow mark starts from C. Then D, D to B, D to E, E to C, E to F, this is F to D, straight line, starts at F, ends at D, so F to D, that is a relation. You can write the relation, okay, write down R as set of ordered pairs, draw the matrix, determine in degree and out degree, you can do that. So, some problems on in degree, out degree, how to write the matrix, digraph and everything. See, as we have seen the union and intersection in the relation, same type of questions will be repeated. Okay, if you understood the fifth chapter very clearly, if you have understood fifth chapter very clearly, you can keep on writing the answers in the sixth chapter, no problem. What are the results? And R, that is what I told, union means R, correct? So, A comma B belong to R, or A comma B belong to S, in any one of the thing it is there, then it will be there in R union S. If it should be there in both the relations, it should be there in R, it should be there in S, then it will be there in R intersection S. This is new now, R bar is the complement of the set R in the universal set A cross B. Again in the set theory chapter, unit 1. By Dr. Gurraj. So, there you have learnt about the complement universal set, same concept you are using, R bar, complement of the universal set A cross B. Be careful, there R bar or R power C, R power C is also a complement there, but here R power C is different. R power C is the converse of R here. What is meant by converse of R? See, the set A comma B will be in R power C if and only if B comma A belong to R. If BA is in R, then A comma B you can write it in R power C, symmetry that we call. In the next coming chapter, in continuation of in this chapter, you will learn I am using the words reflexive, symmetry, those things you are going to get in the continuation of this chapter. So B comma A is in R, then A comma B belong to R power C. This also one more result. MR is a matrix of R, then MR power T transpose. What is the transpose? Rows will be written in terms of columns. So automatically the elements will be changed. AB, it will be changed to BA. So that will be there in R power C. So please note that here R bar is the complement, whereas R power C is the converse, it is not complement. In set theory, if it is R bar or R power C, one and the same, no changes. But here R bar is the complement, R power C is the converse. See the problem. Let A is equal to B is equal to 1, 2, 3. They give you the relations also. R is 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1. Yes, 2, 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. Compute R union S, R intersection S, R bar, S bar, R converse, S converse. This afterwards, after doing this, this you have to do it as an assignment. Draw the diagrams of all the relations. See, for clarity, in the next slide also, determine the in degree and out degree, write the matrices. In each question, I am giving this so that you can practice it very neatly. Now, for clarity, whatever given in the problem, R and S we have taken. This is R, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, and it is given in the problem. S also given in the problem. What I should write? What is R union S? It may be in R, it may be in S, or in both. So 1, 1, yes, 1, 1. 1, 2, 1, 1, not present in R, sorry, S, even though. 1, 2, not present in S, even though. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, okay. Then 2, 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. All the elements will come in the tier. But please note that 3, 1 is intersection element. That's what I told. Both, it is there in both, but you write only once, 3 comma 1. So here it is known, already I told, R intersection S, it should be in both. So 3 comma 1 element is there in both, therefore R intersection S is 3 comma 1. Now R bar, S bar, these two are complements, these two are complements, that's why I have written A cross B. What is the set A? What is the set A? 1, 2, 3. So we write in a B is also 1, 2, 3. So write A cross B. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3 as usual. Now, complement, you find, you leave the elements R in A cross B, remaining elements. You have seen 1, 1 was there. 1, 2 was there. 1, 3 was there. But 2, 1 is not present. Sorry, 1, 3 is also not present. 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2. Then 3, 2, 3, 3. See R, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1. Leave that element. 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3. You leave that elements, remaining elements you write, it is R bar. Similarly, S. What are the elements in S? 2, 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. So 2, 1. That's why we have written all 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. 2, 1, 2, 2. Then all these elements are present. 3, 1, 3, 2. So 2, 3. What is converse? I told you clearly, converse. If A comma B belong to R, you should have B comma A in R power C. In other words, B comma A in R power C, you should have AB in R power C, R. So 1 by 1 element, 1, 1 is there in R, so we have written 1, 1. 1, 2 is there in R, I have written 2, 1. 2, 3 is there in R, I have written 3, 2. Then 3, 1 is there in R, therefore, I can write 1 comma 3. Same way for S, 2, 1, so 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, R bar, S bar, R converse, S converse. So only this much I am showing in the slide. Remaining you have to work. Okay, remaining whatever the other questions are asked. What are the other questions? Draw the diagrams for each. Then determine in degree, out degree for each. Write the matrices. Okay. For all R union S, R intersection S, R bar, S bar, R power C, S power C, you have to write the inverse and diagram in degree, out degree, matrices, everything. The problem may be like this also. The digraphs of R and S are given. This is the digraph of R. I told you how, what is the meaning of this, because in computer, in the slides, we are not able to draw it properly. This represents 3, 3. This represents 5, 5. This represents 4, 4. So, what is the relation? 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. Only 3, 3 is there. 4, 4, 4, 3, 4, 5 and 5, 5 is there. That is the relation R. Same way relation S in one more digraph. Okay. So, this is 1 to 1 represents, this is 2 comma 2, this is 3 comma 3, this represents, I am very clear about it. So, this is the digraph of S. From this you write the relation R, relation S, write R and S as ordered pairs, you have to write it, then compute R union S, R intersection S, R bar, S bar, R power C, S power C. Determine the in degree and out degree of the vertices in the digraphs, write the matrices. Meaning of this, in degree, out degree for each, for R union S you should write, R intersection S, R bar S, because you have written all digraphs. You have to write all digraphs and write the in degree, out degree, then write the matrices for each case. You can see the continuation of this topic, how we have done the relation function, relations and functions, same way it is moving. Okay, Cartesian product, relation, function, then we have seen composition of relation, composition of function. Here we are seeing composition of relations, how you can amalgam two relations. Okay, what is a composition? Composition of relation. R is a relation from A to B and S is a relation from B to C. Same way function also, F is a function from A to B, G is a function from B to C. Same way, R is a relation from A to B, S is a relation from B to C. Then R composite S, it consists of ordered pairs A power C. When this A comma C will be in this R composite S? Whenever there exist B belong to B with A comma B should be in A and B comma C should be in B. See here, AB is this element, BC is this element. So, the B you can remove, you can write the ordered pair A comma C, it will be in this composition relation. Okay. So, composition relation, AB should be in A, BC in B, then its composition A comma C will be in composition R composition S. See the problem, A is 1, 2, 3, 4. And R, relation R, R is given and S is given. Be the relations on A, find R composite S, S composite R, R square, R cube, S square, S cube. What is meant by R square? R composite R, R cube, R composite R. Already we have seen F, G, H in the functions, same way here also. So, this is R, this is S. What is R composite as? You find out. Okay. By writing the pictorial diagram, you can find very easily this one. Okay. I will show you the pictorial diagram, how you can draw for one. See, in the composition of functions also, I have seen you, shown you the one pictorial diagram. Same way here. Okay. So, let me take. Okay. So, A is 1, 2, 3, 4, all are same sets only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, again 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the relation R? 1 to 1, yes, relation R, 1 to 1, 1 to 3, it is not a function, so this is allowed. So, 1 to 1, 1 to 3, then 3 to 2. Then 3 to 2, 3 to 4, 3 to 4, then 4 to 2. This is the relation R. Now the relation S. relation, yes, 2 to 1, 2 to 1, then 3 to 3, 3 to 3, then 3 to 4, 3 to 4, then 4 to 1, here 2 is left out, it is not a problem, okay. What is R composite as? What is R composite as? 1, 2, 3. See here, 1 is going to 3, again 3 is moving to 3. So, 1, 2, 3. 2 left out, leave it, no problem. 3 is going to 2, again 2 is going to 1. So, 3 comma 1. 3 comma 1, then 1, okay, 3 comma 1, correct, then 1 to 3, 3 to 4, 1 to 3, 3 to 4, so I'll have 1 to 4, 1 to 4, correct, then 4, 4 to 2, 2 to 1, so 4 comma 1. No other elements exist, you can see. Wherever it is there, two arrow marks, that is what you have to consider. See here, 1 to 1, it is not moving, leave it. 1 to 3, 3 to 3, so 1 to 3. Then 1 to 3, 3 to 4, therefore 1 to 4. Then from this 3, 2, there is no arrow marks, leave it. 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, so 3 to 1. Okay. Then 3 to 4, 4 to 1. Again, it is also 3 to 1 only, we have written already. Then coming to 4, 4 to 2, 2 to 1, therefore 4, 1. R composite, yes. Okay, this is how we have to write the pictorial diagram and you can write. Already I have shown in the functions also, same way in the relations I am showing. Correct, you can see the slide, R composite, yes is that one. Similarly, you can draw the pictorial diagram and you can calculate what is S composite. R also, S composite R, okay. So, R square, R cube, all calculated, R cube, R square is R composite R, same way you draw the pictorial diagram, you can write. Then R cube, it is R square composite R, it is R cube, yes, it is given S square, then S cube, okay. See, with this, I am concluding today's session. Still, there are so many things to go. We will continue in the next classes. Probably after 1 or 2 weeks, I may be continuing the same topic. Okay, still, I need 3 more classes. So, within that 3 more classes, I will complete the unit 6.